Yeah, what did you stumble upon? What is this account that I figure
CPJ,
I should already follow?
CPJ Vintage Collectibles. Couldn't sleep last night. I think I woke up at 2 in the morning, 2:30. I'm just laying in bed, and I picked up my phone. I started scrolling.
Crippling anxiety?
And I don't know what it was. I don't know what's going on with me. It's not good. CPJ Collectibles, CPJ Vintage Collectibles, and the guy has a TikTok page, a YouTube page. He has a website. You can buy all this stuff. But we live in the age of, A, the internet, where you can find stuff. B, where stuff is still around.
Mm-hmm.
Like, stuff that our dads played with, it's all but gone.
My dad played with a can
yeah.
and a stick,
if they
I'm
even
pretty
had
sure.
toys, any yeah. toy they had are just long gone.
Like a stuffed squirrel with googly eyes.
But stuff from, like, the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, it's yeah. all still floating around out there. A lot of it. And you can find it. And it's not even toys. Here, listen to this one. This one split my... It's one of those things where you look at that, and you haven't thought about or seen it in 40 years, and you go, oh... my God.
Throwback time. Remember this iconic drink setup from your childhood? The Tupperware pitcher with the squeezable lid thing. Then you had to have Tupperware cups. I always got orange for some reason.
With and then the you plunger in the top. Yes, yes. I kept it fresh.
It did it?
I don't know what it did.
It
did
it. My dad
I had that pitcher. I know.
Throwback
I had
time.
That
remember
pitcher.
This iconic drink
okay,
setup?
I could see the underside of that lid. You flip the lid
look,
over, it's got ridges
it.
All
yes.
the
look.
Way around. Oh, I Dude. Had that thing.
And it had the little, it was a Tupperware thing, and it was back when Tupperware was a big thing, and it had a little plunger in the middle of it.
Yeah.
And it's like, what, the plunger was supposed to do what? I'm not exactly sure, but then he also brings up Tang.
Yeah.
Then this other one right here
yes.
split my, this is going back a little bit further, but this one split my mind open. The noise alone made me
back
freak
before
out.
Before iPads and iPhones, we had some pretty neat stuff to keep us entertained as kids, like this Fisher-Price movie viewer. Now, it came with a bunch of different cartridges that you would load in.
A giant
if you hold it up to the light and turn this crank, it would play a movie. So let's test it out.
All right, here we go. Let's see if this unlocks a memory for any of you.
And you turned this
wow.
wheel, and it's Snow White and the Seven Dwarves, and you would watch.
You no that's what we used kids. To this do. That TV. Used to be a
My
movie.
My daughter sits on the couch now with an iPad.
Watching something in 4K.
I used to clunk in this huge cartridge and spin this thing and
just
go, oh, my
it.
God, it's Snow White.
It's yeah. amazing. It's like I'm at the movies. Would it show a clip of the movie or the whole movie?
Just a clip.
Like a 10 to 15 second clip.
And it's like I just started. It's so weird, the memories that came flooding back.
410-338-1098. What is the toy, something from your youth, something from the past that would be the thing that has the memories, the good times rolling back? This just drills down on something I've said for years now. We live in the nostalgia economy. No generation has looked back more than this one. Our parents never looked back, maybe a little bit. Our grandparents definitely didn't. But this generation is trying to get its youth back more than any other.
Yeah.
And I'm neck deep in it.
You may want to talk to this guy. See, CPJCollectibles.com. I'm on his website. He has 15 pages of G.I. Joe stuff.
And some of the stuff, by the way, it's good. When I say, like, nostalgia economy or looking back too much, if it puts you in a good headspace, man, if you're buying a toy or some stuffed animal or a board game, gets that head where it needs to be, go nuts. This is mine. I don't have audio of it. There's nothing really to play. You're the musician, Joe. Do you remember the Casio SK1 keyboard?
Of course.
It was about this big. It was very small. It ran on four AA batteries, uh-huh. but it had a very special feature where it had a microphone on the corner.
And you could talk into it and then play your
play
voice on the keys.
Right. Yes. What is that? It's yes. playing it back. Yeah, and you would just say something like, boobies, 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 boobies. You'd play like
right.
Happy Birthday or Hot Cross Buns or Chopsticks.
Make
on
a fart
there.
Sound into it.
Fart, 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 fart. It was the best. What about you, Gabby? Is there a toy, something that could take you back to a young DePaula when you weren't in your 40s?
I'm looking at everything now, like Polly Pockets. Does your daughter still play with Polly Pockets?
Hell no.
You're 30 now.
You're old. She's 10.
Do you think about, like, there's not even, like, a commercial for these toys anymore?
Yes, there
Remember?
Is. Trust
for
me.
For toys?
It's on kids' program.
Yeah, put on Disney Channel, put on Nickelodeon, put
That's
on all
probably,
that. It's like...
I don't remember ever
And now as a grown-up, when you watch... the kids' toys commercial. You're like, they just were brainwashing us.
Oh, they
it's
are.
All,
what about
just
the McDonald's
insanity?
Like Happy Meal toys? They still do that?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
But you see it happen to your own kid, and you're like, oh, my God. It's almost isn't fair that they're able to run these ads during kids' programs.
Do you want to get mom to love you? You need the new Polly Pocket doll. She works hard at being your mom, and you should be Polly's mom if you want to have your mom love you.
It's an incredible account. It's CPJ Collectibles on Instagram, and it's just, it's like a digital Smithsonian through a history of toys from the 90s, 80s, 70s, 60s, way back.
You know what else he has a bunch of? What I'm going through the page here.
What does he got?
45s.
Oh, the miniature albums?
Remember the 45s, the singles?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
Physical media.
Love those.
What is the toy that you can just look at and go, God, it takes me back to a better place? A lot of people saying classic Nintendo games, trying to blow in the cartridge. Others people say the Bop It. A lot of people saying the Beanie Babies. Hey, Ron, what's up? Hey, Ron, grow that beard back. The classic all-metal yellow Tonka truck.
Tonka truck.
You could hear that toy before you saw it.
Oh, back when, like, every kid wasn't going to cut, or they did cut their fingers off because it was made out of metal. I think they still make some Tonkas out of metal.
Some, but not as many. I mean, the original Transformers, a lot of them were metal, and then they went to all plastic, and then now they're nothing but plastic. Myers, he says he is the Teddy Ruxpin audio cassettes.
That's right.
My first toy memory in a lot of TMNT. Wow. Jeremy wants to find a Technodrome. Stamboni, we didn't ask you. What's that toy from your broken youth?
I'm going through his page as well, and I'm seeing a lot of the Fisher Price kitchen, the kid kitchen sets.
Yes,
Polly Pockets. Yep.
Get her a Polly Pockets.
Yeah, she's said that. It's the
fifth time.
What about
the yellow and red car? The one that's in the front yard of every decrepit home.
Every house.
The one where you could always smell grandma before you see her. The car looks like an egg.
Mm-hmm.
It's got a name. And I mean, anybody
classic, though,
worth their weight in Waldorf genetics has one of those things somewhere with weeds growing around it.
I actually got my house and I went to my mom's house and went through her attic and I got all of my 80s and 90s kids toys.
Hell yeah, dude. Dude, go rummaging
What's
through that
there?
Stuff.
I got,
you might
dude,
be sending
I got,
all money.
Nah, it's not. I didn't take care of any of my stuff.
Ah, okay, never mind.
But no, I got some cool stuff. I got Rugrats toys and Ren and Stimpy stuff and I have a Michael Jordan doll from when he was in,
Really?
Space Jam. Yeah.
Take some of that
Pee-wee
stuff
Herman
and all-time toys. They're in, where'd they move to? I think they're in Sykesville now.
But see, that's the thing. I would never get rid of it.
What about big wheels? Are big wheels still a thing? Do kids still drive big wheels?
I don't think they do.
Dude, the big wheel used to be the greatest thing on the planet.
I think they do.
If they do, I haven't seen one.
And then you had one with, like, the little e-brake, and you would pull the e-brake and skid out.
Dude, you do the sickest, Tokyo Drift. They had the Rambo one that had a machine gun on the front of that son of a bitch. Shoot your friend! Yeah, those things were sick. Let's go to the phones. 410-338-1098. Trucker Ron, appreciate you holding. What was that toy that you could just look at, you could just hold, and the memories flood back? Oh, hold on. That's JR. My bad. What's up, Trucker Ron?
What's up? Hot Wheels and Matchbox cars.
Dude.
Yeah.
I used to go up to town. I'd say, Mom, going uptown. That's what we call it. You ride your bike into town. We went uptown and we would go to the, it was a stationery store. And do you remember what they used to have? They had a little spindle and it had all of the available Matchbox cars in it. You would spin the spindle and then you would say, give me like whatever number it was, like C18. Yep. And they would get it and they put it in the box for you. You take it home.
If you can find, by the way, I'm not sure if you have any of these, Ron, the 1969 pink rear-loading VW Beach Bomb has sold for as much as $100,000, and the 1970 Mad Maverick has sold for $15,000.
Go ahead. What were you saying? Yep.
They're the most collectible, those two that you just mentioned right there.
Those are the big ones.
Dude, I love the Matchbox.
I remember riding my bicycle from home to Toys R Us in Glen Burnie and buying Matchbox cars.
Hell
and my dad one time brought me and my brother home a box. He got them from somewhere, box of Hot Wheels cars. We spent hours and days just playing with them and I wish I still had all those. I still have quite a few.
I know. You want to almost reach through a portal in time and squeeze your old, yeah, younger self's head going, what the? Stop, yep, holding your G.I. Joes up to the stationary bike wheel to shave down Destro's head so you could see what's underneath of his metal mask. Now let's jump to JR. Good old Jim Ross. What's up, pal?
Good morning, gentlemen and lady.
What's up?
I'd have to say Voltron.
Yeah. Now, do you know that there were two Voltrons, JR?
Voltron Gundam, or Gundam, and then the original. I can't remember the name of it. But
one was made of lions. Everybody knows the lion one.
Yeah,
what was the other one?
The other one was like spaceships.
I'm going to give it to you. It looked like cars and ships. I'm putting him on hold, give him my home address. He gets to come live with me. Way to go, JR. Appreciate you, buddy. Yeah, dude, there was one that was like 20 cars all mashed together.
Vivid memory. Jimmy Douglas, he lived three houses down across the street, had the full Voltron with all the lions. So what was it? It was five of them?
Five of them. Yeah, the black
the head,
one,
the
yellow,
two arms,
red,
and
blue,
the two legs, right?
Green.
Oh,
yeah, yeah.
Dude.
Yeah, the big son of a bitch in the center.
Yep.
And then I never saw the toy that had all the cars, but there was even a crossover cartoon. The lion was the big one. That was the big one. By the way, Trucker Ron, if you're still listening, Toys R Us still exists in the island nation of Japan. It was one of the highlights of the trip. I couldn't believe it. It was a two-story, packed Toys R Us. I guess they just closed here because we can't have nice things. Let's go to our pal. We saw him on Friday at the stables of Westminster. What's up, Chris?
What's up, gentlemen? How are you, Scotty, Justin? Good to see you, young lady. Everybody knows I love my Ghostbusters and all that stupid crap, but there was one toy that nobody had back in 92, 93. Tyco was pushing the Incredible Crash Dummies.
They had a cartoon, right? They had a cartoon, too?
And it was a cartoon. It was a Nintendo game. It was a toy set. But that main set that you could throw crash dummies through the wall.
Oh, hell yeah.
Pieces. You would lose them, and you felt like you were breaking them, but you just did it over and over and over, and it was the initial start of being, you know, I guess a boyhood, because we like to destroy things.
And Chris has had five instances of vehicular manslaughter since.
Oh, you just cracked open another memory.
Oh, no.
Crossbows and catapults.
Yes,
you ever play that?
I remember crossbows and catapults. Do you remember, what was the one that had the gigantic board with a submarine, and you could fire the sub? It had little discs that shot out.
No, I don't remember
what
that.
What the hell was
but
that?
My brother and I played crossbows. Dude, and you know what I bought? They still have it. I bought it for Stella. We play crossbows. They don't have crossbows anymore. They just have catapults.
They just have catapults
but
now?
You build a castle, and you have to knock down the other person's castle.
Look up right now before we jump. Torpedo Run.
Yes!
Torpedo Run!
Torpedo Run!
Run! With yes! I'm paying top dollar for Torpedo Run if anybody's
that's
got
right.
one.